As I said, we've seen IG block and the generative block and replay block and can block. So this is a transmission branch. Okay. So each one will be indicating with a small alphabetical order. Okay. So when you are trying to send the IG block, it will be marked as IG. When you are trying to send a generative block, it will be marked as a G. If it's a replay block, it will be marked as the R. Okay. So since we are going to see capital programming, once you're going to insert a capital programming, you need to right click into this button and you need to insert capital programming. Okay. So the P mark will come. Okay. This will be the programmable message generation. Okay. By using this only, we are going to write our programming, capital programming. So once you double click that P, the capital browser will be open to your system. Okay. So we can start our coding session in that one. Okay. Once you started it, so you can play with your capital programming. Okay. What is capital programming? We already discussed why we are using capital programming. What is capital programming? Okay. Capital is nothing but CAN as programming language, can be created network node models and special valuation programs in for individual applications. Okay. So capital is we can call it event language. Okay, event oriented language, and it can't be interrupted by any other thing. So event means, so there will be an event called a key event, and timer event will be there. So each programming block of in capital is called as the event. So once you started it on, it will be run using the procedural thing. Okay, you cannot interrupt anything in that one. So once you started the programming, you will keep on the procedural kind of thing, which means a top to down approach. Okay, so these are the learning steps to explore the capital programming. Okay, so we understand about the basic operation of the canalizer, how to use the measurement setup and the statistics trace window, and how to save the configuration, how to enable the programming mode, how to enable the generator block, how to log the data, CAN communication data, and kind of things. So these are all the basic steps to reach the capital programming. Okay, so adding the programming blocks, as we discussed, by using the P programming node, we can create a capital programming node, and creating and using a database. Okay, message database. So even for every network, we can create a message. Okay, so the group of message will be the databases. Say it is, you have 10 messages for your testing. So the group of 10 messages will be called the database messages. So whenever we are call it as, you have given one message ID is a name as 100, 200, 300, 400. So you can name that one. That's 200 is identifier, and you can give the name of it. Like 100 is the powertrain, 200 is the safety bag. Like that, you can name it. Okay. So the database will be having the name, identifier, datas. What are the datas you are going to send? Okay, and signals. So each database will be having the information. Okay, since the CAN is a 8 byte data, each bit you can configure. Okay. So where we will be creating a database. Okay. Then we will be, by using this database, we can create a program. Okay. Okay, so these are some of the characteristics of capital. Okay, so we have already mentioned earlier, it's like a C programming language. So if you know C programming, you don't need to worry about lot about this. So you can directly jump into the programming session. Okay, and it's event based. Since that event will be having a key event, message event, timer event, or a system variable which is switch key switches. You can give any, you know, any event, and it can be interrupt. Okay, so we already discussed about a capital browser. So capital browser is nothing but where we are going to write our program. Okay, and later on, capital become more usable to a lot of people. So again, it came with some special features, like to add the DLL, add INI file, like that. Okay, and capital is divided in three distinct parts. Okay, that is global variable declaration. It's like C programming, like how you declare a int, char, struct, or anything like that, and event procedures. So we are going to discuss about the event procedure, what is event procedures and all, and user defined functions. So how C functions will work, the same way our capital functions also will be work like that. Okay. Okay. So here we are going to discuss about the events in capital. Okay. So events in capital, like there are five types of event in the capital. Okay, so if you open the canalizer, there will be one start and stop button will be there. Okay, so where the start will work, once you click the start button, it will start the CAN communications. Once if you stop it, it will stop the CAN communication in the network. So it is also considered as a on start on stop. Okay, so it is also considered as a event. So whenever you are going to write a program, so if you want anything like a pre-processing, so while you are starting the CAN, you need to initialize some messages, like I need to send some CAN message into the network, like that you can declare in the on start event. So likewise, the on stop button. So once you click the stop button, there are some functionality you can change, like you can make every variables as zero, like that. So initialize or deinitialize in by using the stop on stop event. Okay, and use a keyboard entry. So if you have our keyboard, there will be having alphabetical letters and numeric letters, and page down page up will be there. By using that also, we can implement our programming. So say it as, whenever I press key A, we can send some message into the network. Whenever I press key 1, you can send some sort of messages, and some sort of test cases will be written for that one. Okay, CAN message reception. So like we are going to talk about more on CAN messages only. So the CAN message, as I said, ID, CAN ID. So whenever this CAN come into the network, you can react for that message. Say if a message called 100, if the 100 message comes, I need to send 200 message into the network. Like that you can write a program, and timer out of the program. So in embedded environment, we will learn about the timers modules. Okay, likewise here also the timer is working as the event. So basically the timers is a MS timer and the second timer. Okay, millisecond and second timer will be there. So we're using that timer, we can do some delay techniques, like whenever I press A, after 5 seconds of delay, some messages has to go into the network. Like that we can do. So it is the nothing but timer event. Okay, user input by a graphical panel. So it is available in CANOE only right now. So graphical panel means like switch on, switch off, key switches, and the speedometer, raising the speedometer, like that. So we can implement those variables also. These are all the events in the capital. So along with that, we have some C kind of functions and variables. Okay. So again, as I said, events in capital. Okay. So this is how the syntax of the events will be declared in the capital. Okay. So start of measurement. So whenever you are going to write a on start message, so write is nothing but it will print the, it will print whatever we have written, it will print in the write window. So we forgot to discuss about one window called write window, which is mainly dedicated for the capital. Okay, so the capital window will be having one window called write window. Whatever you are want to write in that window, you can write using this write function. Okay, so on start, I'm going to write start of canvas. What it will do in the programming side, once you declare this one, it will write the start of canvas in the write window. Okay, same ways, all the write, whatever you have written as a write, it's nothing but a printf function in C programming. Okay, so as I said, nearly we have the five events. For example, message received. So message received, on message, which means whenever this message is coming to the network, message ID, it's a declaration on message space 0x123. So if you have the database already created, you can write directly the name of the message. Okay, so whenever the message comes 123, it will write as can message 123 in the write window. Same wise on signal temp, there will be we can write some signal in that one. So on signal temp, it will write the signal temperature in the write window. Same timer event, it is not on time, it's on timer. Okay, I mistaked it. On time, whenever we will be declaring a timer variable, we are going to see how to declare those variables. Okay, whenever a timer cycle, it will write the within the cycle. So key press event, whenever you are pressing the key, it will write as the as a given. Okay. Apart from event, it is as we said, it's like a C programming. It will have the keywords. Okay. The keywords cannot be the name of the variable or function. Okay. So there are some basic keywords which is used in C programming. Same will be used here: break, case, care, continue, default, do, else, float, if, int, long, return, switch, while. Okay, so before some versions of canalizer, we don't have the privilege to use a structure function into the can. After that, it is implemented a structure, and still now union we can't use, and pointer. So those are some restrictions in the capital. So we can use very minimal thing in which is utilized in the embedded C. Okay, we cannot implement the same thing whichever we used in the C programming. Okay, coming to the data types of the capital, it is nearly five. It is five types of data types we have, which is available. Okay, integer data type, float data type, single character, message variable, and timer variable. Okay, so we know that integer will be having signed and unsigned. There will be a int, long, byte, d word, word, q word. So the bit of the variable. Okay, floating point, whatever we want to play with the floating variables, we can use the float variable, float or double float. Single character, using character also we can declare the character, the capital. Message variable. So apart from the single, float, and integers, these are new to the capital: message variable and timer variables. Okay, so message variables for can message. So again, there is upgraded version. We can use some Ethernet variables also, and J139 variable, UDS protocol variables also we can use in the message variable section. And timer variable, it is very limited. We have only two timer variables, one is MS and the timer. Okay, we will see the one by one message variables and timer variables in upcoming slides. So we already discussed about the key press event. Okay, so whatever it's available in our keyboard, we can use this keyword by using this on key variable. Okay, so whenever you are using on key and make this A, it might be a space bar, F1 key, control F1 to page up, home, star. Okay, so these are all very unique. A and space bars, F1, control F, and page up. These are all the we know about it. What is star? Okay, whenever you use on key, star means it might be anything. Okay, whatever you key press, it will react. Which means star is nothing but the all. Okay, so I want to send some messages. Whenever I press some keys. Okay, I want to send one message called 100. If I press any key, means if I press G, it will transfer the message of ID of 100. Okay, into the network. That is how the key press will work. Okay. Okay, so how we are declaring the variables in Capital? Okay, we will come to the programming session. Okay, so if you take the Capital browser, there will be one. This like a whiteboard will be there. Okay, so each functions for which you are talking, on start, on key, on stop, on messages, will be having the first session called variables. Okay, so where we will declare and initialize our variables here. Okay, so see, first one is the first example is we'll have the normal C programming like int I is equal to 1. So we are declaring and initializing the integer variable here and character variable char A and canary. Okay, it's all the variables how we will be declare as same as C programming. Okay. And the example two is the Capital oriented declaration. Okay, so as we discussed it, we have two variables which is new to the embedded C. Okay, which is called timer and message event. Okay, so before we are going to use the timer, we need to declare the timer. Okay, so how we will declare the timer? Timer delay timer. Timer is the keyword. And delay timer is the variable. Okay, MS timer is equal to cyclic timer. Okay, so if you see there is a timer and MS timer. Timer is a second time variable. MS time is the millisecond timer variable. So whenever you use the timer, it will calculate in the second. Whenever you use the MS timer, it will calculate as the millisecond timer. Okay. Okay, so we seen the how to declare the timer variable and the normal C variables. Okay, so coming to the messages. Okay, message may be anything. So you may have saved in the database, or if you didn't save anything, you can directly write as a message 0xA as M1. Okay, message is the keyword and using this message ID, and we are giving the name as a M1. Okay, like that 100 engine data, which is a symbolic declaration, which will be having they are already saved in the database. Okay, so without ID also we can declare the messages like star. As I said, star is nothing but all. Okay, so okay, we are declaring the messages and how these messages will be react in the Capital. Okay, so basically we will be discussing about the messages nothing but a CAN messages. Okay, so CAN message will be having the ID, DLC. DLC means data length of the CAN data. Okay, identifier we already seen, it's nothing but a 0xA, and the channel A or channel 1. So basically the channel will be having two channels. So in which channel we are going to send, channel A or channel B, channel 1 or channel 2. Okay, So you have written a set of a frame of a message, like you have a byte of nearly a 3 byte of message you are going to send, like 00 01 02, you are going to send to the network. How are you going to send? You declared as the message 01A. So you have written some key event called on key. Whenever you are pressing A, you need to send a message called ML. Okay. How are you going to send? By using the function called output. So whenever using the output, the whatever you are going to send, by using this output function, it will send to the CAN network. Okay. CAN listener network. Okay. This is how we are going to send. Okay. So it's a timer. Okay, what is timers? We already discussed about timers. We have two timers, like MS timer and timer. Timer is second and MS timer is a millisecond. Okay. Whenever we are calling that, so it will wait for that time. Once it is expired, it will start working on it. Okay. So how we are going to configure this timer? By using the function called set timer. Okay. So by using this set timer, we can call. So you already declared as a MS timer time. Okay. MS timer A, the millisecond timer, which has the name of A. Okay. So this set timer has the two parameters in it. One is the name of the timer, which is A, and the length of the timer to this set the timer, which means I want to send that for 100 millisecond. So in this function, you need to write like set timer, open bracket, A, comma, 100, close comma. Okay. So whenever you set the timer, it will start working on the timer, which take it as the timer A. We are doing performing some simulations. Once it's completed, you need to cancel timer. Okay. So by using this cancel timer, you can cancel the timer which you have declared. Okay. So cancel timer A, finished. Okay. So the usage of timer we are using here, variable, I'm using MS timer, my timer, and the message 100 MSG, and I'm using the key event. Whenever I'm pressing key event, I need to start the timer. Okay. The timer of the 20 millisecond. Okay. So it will, once I press the K event, it will come to here, set timer, my timer, and it will come to on timer. Whenever my timer is started, it will come here on timer. So my timer is going to work here. Okay. What is given in the my timer? So for 20 millisecond, I need to send message of 100. Whatever I have written is a message, it will send to the CAN network. This is how our CAN, the timer will work. Okay. Once the 20 millisecond is completed, it will send the message which has the ID of 100. Okay. Okay. So we have seen how we are declaring the variables, how we are declaring timers, how we are declaring the messages. Okay. So once you did all, how you are going to execute it into your canalizer. Okay. For everything, it's a compilation is the process. It will compile the code and it will give the executable code to you. Okay. Like same thing, the compilation process will be taken here in the canalizer also. So once you press F5 and shift plus F9, will compile the code. If you got any error, it will throw the error in the error window. So by using that one, you can see how to correct the errors and you can recompile your capital. So once you compile it, you need to start the canalizer. Okay, then only the capital will work. Okay. So if there is any compiler error, the capital program will not allow you to run the canalizer. Okay. So this is how we are going, our compilation process will be taken care. So you have to create a capital code and compile the capital code. Compilers, yes, it will ready to execute. If no, it will come again. You need to correct your errors, and again you need to compile your code. Okay, so then only it will allows you to run the capital program into your kernelizer. Okay, so it will save as the extension called .can file. So once the successfully completed compilation, it will save as a .can file. So whenever you want to edit or run or that, you can read that one and you edit and you compile and you can run into the network. Okay, so it is the executable file wherever it will be work. Wherever the user have the kernelizer, they can use the .can file as a program, and they can simulate their environment in the kernelizer.